श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं साधना रघुनाथान्वितां तां सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनासहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णान् पदान् साधना ललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितां हे कृष्णा करुणा सिन्धो दीनबन्धो जगत्पते गोपेशा गोपिका कान्ता राधा कान्ता नमोऽस्तु ते सप्त काञ्चन गौराङ्गी राधा वृन्देवनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये वाञ्छा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धोभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधार श्रीवादादि गौर भक्तवृन्द हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण आई वेलकम ऑल द डिवोटीज इन द Leelamrita reading session. Today we are reading chapter 2, opening a temple in Los Angeles. We are going to start reading from one day after a walk. So Mataji, if anybody would like to start, Mataji?
Yes, Mataji, I can start reading, Mataji.
Okay.
One day after a walk, Prabhupada told Aniruddha that Los Angeles reminded him of Mumbai and that he wanted to build a very big temple in Los Angeles. Although Aniruddha was not one of the endure hard of for building a big temple, Prabhupada still told him his vision. Another day, Prabhupada called Aniruddha in and showed him the deity of Radha Krishna that Gaura Sundar and Subala had carved. Prabhupada's eyes were shining. I want to have Radha Krishna deity in everyone's home, he said. Aniruddha was amazed by the joyful expression on Prabhupada's face. What can I do? Aniruddha asked. I want you to go to different founders and find out the cost of casting deity. Aniruddha and Subala then phoned and visited various foundries in Los Angeles and area, returning with information, but their investigation were unbusinesslike and not well thought out. Knowing this, Prabhupada smiled and asked, so what intelligent news do you have for me today? Aniruddha knew Prabhupada was criticizing him, but he would only giggle in return. He loved it. One morning, Aniruddha went to see Prabhupada with what he considered a frightening story. Before dawn, he had been out in the park collecting the
eucalyptus
twigs. Thank you, Komadiki Mataji, for Prabhupada to use a toothbrush. He had been standing on the park beach cutting the branch of a tree with his knife when a police car had suddenly pulled and a policeman had rushed out of the car. What are you doing? Policeman demanded. Aniruddha explained that he was getting toothbrush for his spiritual master. The policeman had said, don't you know that tree belongs to city? They belong to the people of California. He had said that Aniruddha could be arrested for carrying a knife open knife. When he had asked Aniruddha what was in the bag around his neck, Aniruddha had shown him his beads. The policeman has then asked if Aniruddha had come from a mental institution. Prabhupada smiled to hear the story and inquired, did you ask him if he was a crazy? Govinda Dasi had been complaining to Aniruddha that Swamiji's apartment was too noisy and crowded, and that way no private bathroom facility for Swamiji. She kept insisting Aniruddha find a better place. Aniruddha, however, was getting only $200 a month from Dayananda, and with Prabhupada's plus so many visitors, there was a financial strain. So Swamiji is very uncomfortable. Govinda Dasi nagged, but Aniruddha did not know what to do. When Aniruddha asked Prabhupada if the place was all right, he said it was. It was. Aniruddha explained that more devotees were eager to visit from San Francisco and would probably want to stay in apartment. Personally, Prabhupada said, I have no suggestion myself. It is up to them, whatever they decide. Prabhupada had his translating to do. But he also wanted to see his disciples for Aniruddha. However, the prospect of more devotees coming to visit was a cause of anxiety. Finally, he had Dayananda found a larger apartment for Swamiji. The new apartment was 4 rooms over a private garage in a rear of an apartment complex. Aniruddha painted, and some of other devotees helped prepare the apartment as comfortable as possible for Prabhupada. Then they moved him in. The landlord, a small Japanese man, came by and seeing Prabhupada seated on the floor beside his trunk, asked, where's your furniture? He seemed suspicious. Prabhupada smiled, thanked him and said, it's all right. We can sit down anywhere. Prabhupada explained, we are mendicant. But after leaving, the landlord kept standing out on the landing, peeking through the window. Tell me to go away, Prabhupada said to Aniruddha. At the temple during the evening program, Srila Prabhupada would sometimes ask one of his disciples to speak after the kirtan. Dayananda, one night as I was driving Swamiji to the temple, he asked me to speak. I immediately thought I would rather not. Although in Swamiji's absence, his another disciple had given a talk, I had never given an informational talk. So I told Swamiji I prefer to hear him speak. But he said he preferred to hear me. So it was settled. I would like to stop here, Mataji. Thank you so much. I read a little more because we are only few people. Hare Krishna.
Thank you so much, Vinaya Mataji. Not a problem. Mataji, Kamaliki Mataji, would you like to go, Mataji? Yeah. Are you on the phone or the laptop, Mataji?
I think she has a book. That's why she corrected me, right?
Okay. Kamaliki Mataji, can you hear me?
Call lo lena tantisindi Supriya.
Oh, okay.
Kanapadutundi gaani call le anukunta anipistundi. Ikkada tana microphone kanapadali kada kanapadachu.
Okay.
Sir, nenu chatna inkoncham.
Okay. Yeah.
Dayananda, one night I was driving Swamiji to temple. He asked me to speak. I immediately thought I would rather not. Although in Swamiji's absence, his other disciples had given talks. I had never given a informational talk. So I already read, right? This one. Prefer to hear him, but he said prefer to hear. So it was settled. At the temple, we had a kirtan as usual, and then I began to speak. I was speaking on the validity of God, trying to improve that God's existence was logical and scientific and reasonable. Such a talk should have been given with reference to Vedic literature, but my fund of knowledge was not embellished by verses from the scriptures, nor was it even adequate based on the Krishna conscious philosophy. I was aware that my talk wasn't adequate. A fact that Sri Prabhupada himself brought home in the sweetest possible way. When at one point I made a mistake, said the wrong thing altogether, Prabhupada, matter of factual, interrupted, explaining the point I had missed. He then motioned me to go on. I continued without any loss of faith. I was being corrected in public, but without the embarrassment that a chastisement might cause. Swamiji, correction was always on love and sincerity in the relation to the goal rather than to ego. On the appearance day of Srila Prabhupada, spiritual master Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, Prabhupada gathered some of his disciples Aniruddha, Govinda Dasi, Gaur Sundar, Nandarani, and a boy named Shankarshan for a special celebration. In the kitchen of his apartment, Prabhupada cooked a feast to his spiritual master. Nandarani brought the flowers and Prabhupada led the devotees in the ceremony of offering the flowers and chanting prayers in honor of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. Nandarani, I had my daughter Chandramukhi. Chandramukhi, me then, she was about 2 months and was sitting very quietly in a little basket in a corner of the room. After the ceremony, Swamiji gathered a handful of flowers, walked over the basket where Chandramukhi was lying, and placed the flowers around her neck, her head, and he smiled and said, "One day I will take you to India with me." After the feast, the devotee followed Prabhupada into his room. He sat and his neck his desk and read the letter aloud to the small gathering of his disciples seated on the floor before him. The letters were appreciation, and these letters became Srila Prabhupada's offering to his spiritual master. Prabhupada read loud statements like, "We really like chanting. We are happy since we met you. We are trying to teach other people how to chant Hare Krishna. Simple sentiments. Reading the letter, Prabhupada became very happy. Then he put the letters along with the flowers before the picture of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. Then looking at Nandarani, he asked, "Have you became happy since you have been chanting Hare Krishna?" "Oh yes," Nandarani replied. "My life is wonderful." Looking at the others, Prabhupada said, "And what about you? Do you feel more satisfied since you have been chanting Hare Krishna?" Then all answered, "Yes. I have only one request," Prabhupada continued, "whatever happiness you have felt, you simply tell someone else about that. That is all you have to do. You need not to teach anything. You do not need to teach the philosophy. You just explain people that because you chant Hare Krishna, you became happy. And if they chant, they will become happy. Then I will be satisfied, and my spiritual master will be satisfied." I would like to stop here, Mataji.
Thank you, Vinaya Mataji.
We'll see Komatiki Mataji on there. Ledante Chadamante Chautan and Lathan Chadutante
Chadamante. No, I don't think so.
Komatiki Mataji?
I was on the mute and I was. I'm sorry, I was on the mute and I was speaking. Can I read?
Yes, Mataji. Yes, we are waiting for you, Mataji.
Okay. As Srila Prabhupada entered the storefront one evening, he was surprised to find Umapati there to greet him. Umapati had left Krishna consciousness almost a year ago, and Prabhupada had not seen him since. Spontaneously, Prabhupada went forward and embraced Umapati. A few months before, Umapati had written, indicating that he was thinking of returning. So his arrival was not a complete surprise to Srila Prabhupada. As Prabhupada took his seat, he asked Umapati about the devotees in New York. Briefly, Prabhupada reminisced how he had begun his movement in New York and how boys like Umapati had helped him. Later that evening, back at the apartment, Prabhupada expressed sadness that some of his disciples had left Krishna consciousness. He told Umapati that when the wife of one of the sannyasi disciples of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati had forcibly dragged her husband away, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati had shed tears over his inability to save the disciple. A disciple, due to Maya's influence, may fall away, Prabhupada said, but the spiritual master will never forsake him. This is a qualification. Hare Krishna. Umapati had left Krishna consciousness because of intellectual doubts. Having been an eclectic follower of Buddhism, he had objected to Prabhupada's explanations of Buddhism. On leaving Krishna consciousness, however, he had simply returned to his old job in a radio station, grown back his beard, and reverted to his old habits. Whenever I saw someone doing something wrong, like eating meat, Umapati explained to Prabhupada, I would think, my spiritual master said this is bad. When you think like that, Prabhupada said, your life at once becomes sublime. Several other devotees entered Prabhupada's room as Prabhupada talked. As a person becomes more Krishna conscious, Prabhupada explained, he becomes concerned not to cause suffering to other living beings. He doesn't want to cause suffering, even to a small insect. Don't you feel? Prabhupada asked, imploring them with his eyes to understand the non-violence of the devotee. Seeing that Prabhupada was almost constantly occupied by various disciples, Lilavati, one of the girls visiting from San Francisco, decided not to take up her spiritual master's time unnecessarily. Prabhupada noticed her frequent absence from the gatherings at his apartment. When she finally visited him, he asked her, why are you not coming? Oh, Swamiji, Lilavati said, you must do your translating work. I don't think you are getting your work done. No, you don't know. You don't know? Prabhupada corrected her mistake. Don't you know my disciples are my work? I'll stop here, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Samadhi Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
So, Mataji. Thank you, Mataji. I will leave, Mataji. Hare Krishna. Prabhupada said he would go to as many speaking engagements as Aniruddha could obtain. Aniruddha got engagements, but there were many difficulties. On two occasions, Prabhupada, Subala and Aniruddha were on their way to an engagement at a college when their car broke down. Another time, a policeman arrested Subala for not having a driver's license, and Prabhupada, accompanied by his servant, had to walk back to his apartment. At an engagement at the UCLA Student Center, not a single student attended. Prabhupada sat waiting for 10 minutes and then returned to the Aniruddha. So what happened? At an outdoor engagement at Long Beach State College, there was no seat for Prabhupada, and Aniruddha had to return and find an umbrella to shade Prabhupada from the sun. Aniruddha, this is not very nice, Prabhupada remarked from the podium. But there were successes also. Mukunda Das arranged for Prabhupada to appear on national television on the Liz Crane show. He also arranged for Prabhupada to appear on the Joy Piney show, as well as on the several radio programs. A Life magazine featured Prabhupada's picture and an accompanying story as part of an article, The Year of the Guru. Although Aniruddha was prepared to arrange preaching engagements for Prabhupada for as long as he would stay, the devotees in San Francisco, New York, Montreal and Boston had repeatedly asked Prabhupada to visit them. He had gone to India in July 1967, returning to San Francisco December 14th.
He had stayed in San Francisco 3 weeks and in Los Angeles 2 months. So while his disciples in San Francisco and Los Angeles had seen him, the others had been waiting for more than 8 months. It was time to move on. On March 7th, the day Prabhupada left Los Angeles, he thanked Aniruddha for his service in maintaining the center. Despite my ill health, he said, I was very comfortably situated. Krishna will bless you. Actually, what did I do, Aniruddha replied? Everything was a mistake. All the engagements were missed. No, Prabhupada said, that's all right. You tried your best. As Prabhupada was leaving for the airport, he had to walk from his apartment to the car. It was raining and he had no umbrella or raincoat. Govinda Dasi frantically ran into the bathroom, tore down the shower curtain and wrapped it around his spiritual master to protect him from the rain. Very spontaneous idea. Prabhupada had unlimited plans for expansion. A big city like Los Angeles deserved a big temple, organized distribution of books on Krishna consciousness and sophisticated cultural programs. And there should be deities of Radha and Krishna in every home. And while enthusiastically planning to make everyone and everything Krishna conscious, Prabhupada waited patiently to see if a stray disciple like Krishna Devi would return. Prabhupada was ready to appear on television or meet Murli with any challenger or travel anywhere in the world, and yet he allowed Govinda Dasi to cover him with a shower curtain against the rain. The Los Angeles temple would become a great Krishna conscious success only with hard work and sincerity, and that Prabhupada knew would take time. His disciples were not yet so well trained as to make formidable advances for Krishna against the forces of Maya. Yet by his staying for 2 months in Los Angeles, he was strengthening his disciples' Krishna consciousness and they would continue to progress. Ascon LA was now a little stronger. A few devotees were going to stay and help. He would come back when they had done more. Okay, Mataji, I would like to stop here and thank you for this opportunity to read today on this special occasion. Hare Krishna.
Mataji, I think we three are there.
So today we will stop here our reading and we will share our realizations, Mataji. So Mataji, Kamodiki Mataji and Vinaya Mataji, can you share your realization? Kamodiki Mataji, would you like to say something, Mataji?
Why? Yeah, this was like, when I see, Hare Krishna, can you hear? Okay.
Yes, Mataji.
Umapati Prabhuji, when he came back, he had left the car, gone back to this thing. And when he came back, he had already written a letter to Prabhupada that he's back. And when he came, so then Prabhupada knew, but still, he was so happy to see him. And so that shows his kindness, how kind he is. If one who has left still comes back, and he just receives him very nice. And then Umapati said, then he was. Then he sees somebody eating meat, and so then he remembers to this. He says, "You know, don't eat meat because it's hurting the other person. Person in a sense, the living entity. I don't know, living bodies because of the soul. Anyway, I don't know why it's." Echoing.
Mataji,
yeah, just then Prabhupada.
Little bit echo is coming.
Is it from me on side, my side?
No, Mataji, because Supriya Mataji's microphone is on when you're speaking because of that. Okay, Mataji, I'll mute it. 1 minute.
I'm so sorry. So then Prabhupada, he's very nice thing. Then what he, Umapati, when he said that, that when somebody eats me, then again he sees it, then he says, oh my, he says, my spiritual mother said this is bad. So then Prabhupada was very happy to hear, he liked it, that they are singing. So then he said, Prabhupada said, your life at once becomes sublime. Because you, then you say, these are the words of spiritual master, that he says that eating meat, drinking and all this is bad. So he remembered this Prabhupada's words. So then Prabhupada was very happy to that somehow he has remembered by seeing this, those people who were eating meat. And I guess so then he says about it, when persons, when they are eating meat, so then they don't think that this is a very, it's a suffering for the that animal, whatever they had given the life for them to eat meat. So the animal had suffered, but they don't see that. So that's what Prabhupada is also concerned about, that it's suffering for the, also the one who eats meat, there is a suffering waiting for that person also. Yeah. Now, and then it, Prabhupada also, like Lilavati, I forget the name, Lilavati, she was visiting, came from San Francisco to where Prabhupada is. I didn't get that before. I think Vinaya Mataji read that there, Prabhupada is. So anyway, so, but Lilavati has, she was thinking that I shouldn't disturb Prabhupada, because he has to write, so I don't want to take his time, and so that was less writing he will do. So that's what her thinking was, and that's why she was not going there. But then finally, when she came there, so then Swamiji said, Prabhupada said, why are you not coming? Prabhupada asked. Then she said, oh Swamiji, because your translating work will not be done, complete, will not be done. So that's why. So Prabhupada said, no, this is also my work. Like he has disciples. So training the disciples is also the spiritual master's duty. And that's what he was saying also. I think that's where I stop here. Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Kamodiki Mataji, for sharing those points. Yeah, whatever you tell Mataji regarding the meat eating and everything, it is wonderful, Mataji. How he got remembered about the spiritual master words.
Yes.
But he is back to his regular non-devotee life, but he remembered what spiritual master told. That is nice, Mataji.
Yeah. So that's what brings him back.
Prabhupada.
Mm. Yes, so any little thing, sometimes we think that it's very insignificant, but it is very significant.
Mm. Yeah, by reading that, Mataji, we have seen that because of his Buddhism and what Prabhupada told about Buddhism, he went back to his regular life, but he did not forget his statement. Yeah, that is true, Mataji.
That was intellectual doubt he had, that's what he said.
Yeah, yes, Mataji, yes. Yeah, thank you so much, Mataji. Vinaya Mataji, would you like to share some more, Mataji?
Sure, Mataji, I would like to share, yeah. In the starting, where I've read is like morning when Aniruddha and Prabhupada was, you know, just walking around, and then they saw in the park he wants to pluck eucalyptus string for the Prabhupada toothbrush, and a policeman saw him using the knife on the road, on the free way, it's not law, that then, you know, he had wanted to arrest him, and then he asked, what is your wearing on the neck and everything,
And then he said that, you know, it's a chanting beats. And then he was asking, are you coming from the, you know, somewhere in a disabled people or mental people case? And he was like, and then Prabhupada was thinking, like, he's a crazy man. That's why, you know, he was asking you all that. And then again, Govindadas, he was not so happy where Prabhupada was staying, because it's very small room and, you know, people are coming, and where the restroom is not also private restroom for the Prabhupada. So so Govindadasi was complaining on Aniruddha, but Aniruddha has no option, because Aniruddha was earning very, very less money. So that is why he was only just getting $200 a month from Dayananda. And so then he was like, he cannot do anything much. So whatever he is the possible, Aniruddha was doing that. But after a few days, he had decided to change the place, and then he got a new place where it's a large apartment, and it was very good. So it was a 4-bedroom house, I guess so. 4-bed apartment, and then, you know, it was very, very nice, and it has a garage and everything, and then it was comfortable. The landlord was a Japanese man, and he was in, like, when Prabhupada was sitting on the floor with his trunk and furniture, he seems like kind of suspicious. Prabhupada smiled and said thank you to him. And then again, Prabhupada was, you know, explaining, he was asking him, like, well, you don't have any furniture or anything. Then he said that I'm a mendicant. And then again, after that, you know, Prabhupada told for the evening program to call some of the devotees for the evening program, and Kirtan, Dayananda and everybody went to take Prabhupada to the temple, and immediately people have came. And then, you know, although Prabhupada was not there, Prabhupada supposed to speak, but there was no option that Aniruddha wanted to speak. He had got opportunity to speak, but he was very scared, but because he never had spoken. He was like literally very scared, because he never had even given introduction speech. But still, he had started speaking, which he wanted to give a scientific and a logical reason for taking up Krishna consciousness, but he could not give that reason properly through the scriptural way. But he was giving some reasons which are not very proper way, because he was thinking that he was not qualified to give the class. Even Prabhupada pointed one mistake. When Prabhupada pointed, he was just corrected that point, and then he started, and Prabhupada told him to continue speaking, and then he continued speaking. So again, you see, we can see that Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur's appearance came. And then everybody was there, like Aniruddha, Govinda Dasi, Gaur Sundar Das, and Nandarani. And she had a little boy named a little girl, actually, I think, right? Nandarani, and a boy named Shankar Shana were celebrating the Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Maharaj appearance day. And Prabhupada himself cooked some of the prasadam, and also they have offered the flowers to Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And then they were doing their prayers and offering the homages to Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. And then after that, Nandarani had a little girl, Yamchandra Mukhi, where she was sitting on the little basket in the corner. And then Prabhupada, you know, after everything was done, Prabhupada went to the little girl and gave her a flowers as a blessing on her head. And he said to her that one day I will take you to India. And then they had got some of the letters into the room. And then everybody were reading the letters that is offering for the Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Maharaj. And then they were all talking, and all the letters were saying that I was so happy by chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra, and we are trying to give this Hare Krishna Mahamantra to many of them, whoever we come into contact. And everybody were so happy because of chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. And then Prabhupada asked people who were present in the room, are you all happy by chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra? Then everybody said, yes, we are happy by chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. So then, Prabhupada said that if you are happy, please don't keep it this happiness with you. Try to spread to everybody so that everybody is happy. That makes me happy and that also makes my spiritual master happy. And then after that, that Umapati left the Krishna consciousness, made little bit upset to Srila Prabhupada. And not also that, some other disciples are also leaving Krishna consciousness. That made upset, and but Umapati came back again, and because he left because of that Buddhism concept, that was very nice when Leelavati gave the when Prabhupada was leaving from the San Francisco, he was going on the airport, and then that time when the rain comes, and then she was covering the Prabhupada with shivering cutting. That was so beautiful. And then again, the another thing was Aniruddha was very disappointed that he could not give Prabhupada very comfortable stay when he was there in San Francisco. When he was expressing his feeling, then Prabhupada said that, no, don't feel like that. You gave your best. I'm very happy that you have served me very nicely. Like that Prabhupada said. And so these are my points, Mataji. If anywhere I made any mistakes, please forgive me. Hare Krishna.
Thank you. Wonderful, Mataji. Wonderful. You covered most of it. Yourself and Kamodiki Mataji covered mostly, Mataji. So, only few points left for me, Mataji. I will try to share, Mataji. So, while talking of a eucalyptus Aniruddha story, we have read in the previous chapters that when Prabhupada was in London, one of his disciples were seeing for the toothbrush of eucalyptus tree. So there they are doing the same thing. They are plucking the eucalyptus stems and keeping aside. There also one of the cops caught them. So at that time, the answer given was very, very like a slap on the policeman's face. The disciple, Srila Prabhupada told that, you people came to our country and taken their valuable jewels, valuable things from our country, and we here are taking little twigs, and for this you are making a big mess or big scene out of this, and telling all this stuff, the policeman could not say anything and went away from front of Srila Prabhupada. That I got to remember, Mataji. And again, coming to Vyasa Puja of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, you have mentioned everything very nicely, Mataji, detailedly. And coming to Umapati's story, so Umapati ran away. In that connection, Prabhupada remembered in his time when his guru, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, had also experienced the same case of what you can say, scenario in his life, or in his lifetime also, when he was a guru, one of his disciples went away because his wife forcefully dragged her away from the Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. At that time also, he could not do it. He was shedding tears in ability to save the disciple. So the same case Prabhupada is telling, that spiritual master, because of the maya, some disciples may go away, may fall away, but spiritual master will never forsake him of whatever they have done, seva, or whatever they have done in the previous time when they are in the association of the spiritual master. That is very beautiful, Mataji. That is a point to be noted. Then again, coming down, we can see, you have mentioned Aniruddha story, then we can see Mukunda Das. So how Mukunda Das is arranging for Srila Prabhupada to appear on TV channels, newspapers, magazines, and we can see a magazine is covering the picture of Srila Prabhupada and seeing an article named The Year of Guru. So these are the kind of improvements, or these are the kind of promotions are taken by Mukunda Das to spread Krishna consciousness through all what we can say, media channels like newspaper, TV shows, or like stage shows, radio shows. So he's trying his best best to propagate Krishna consciousness. And down from there, we can see how Aniruddha was prepared to arrange preaching arrangements for Prabhupada in San Francisco, New York, Montreal, and Boston also. So he was planning all these things. Then after that, we can see. So here the last part is very beautiful. So while Prabhupada was leaving for airport, it was like raining. It was raining started, and at that moment and at that place, there was nothing to cover his body or cover his head like umbrella or raincoat. And Govinda Dasi very spontaneously went into bathroom and tore the shower curtain and wrapped it around the spiritual master. And it was beautifully explained how Srila Prabhupada accepted this shower curtain. How it is explained means Srila Prabhupada, how he had achieved so much success in spreading Krishna consciousness and making so many disciples, and he wanted to make Radha Krishna to be in each and every home, and he was doing in a very large scale. And at this moment, and he was very popular in TV and magazines also because of his disciples. But at this moment, what Govinda Dasi did, it doesn't matter. So Srila Prabhupada accepted it. However, disciples are serving him. Srila Prabhupada accepted it. So by seeing this scenario, I got to remember the scenario of a story in Ramayana, how Bhakta Shabari offered the fruits tasted by her. She wanted to taste the fruits and she wanted to offer it to Lord Rama. We can see how Lord Rama is magnanimous. He is a king, great king, and he is also a god. We can see how he is the god of entire universe, and he is a great king on the land at that yuga also. But keeping aside all these things, how Lord Rama accepted with love and devotion whatever Bhakta Shabari gave, I think the same thing Srila Prabhupada is accepting. Out of love, Govinda Dasi, she want to protect the spiritual master. She is doing all this stuff, and he accepted this. So I was correlating with the same theme, Mataji. So this was wonderful. And we can see how Srila Prabhupada want to develop Los Angeles temple and make it a very huge temple and make it a very, we can say it like a Krishna conscious, deep Krishna conscious temple in Los Angeles. He was trying hard to make this as a pure devotee's place where all come and stay and could develop this temple, Mataji. Yeah, thank you so much, Mataji, for giving me this opportunity to share, Mataji. And if there are any more, Mataji, please share, Mataji. All the knowledge to Srila Prabhupada on this special occasion. Jai Srila Prabhupada.
Thank you, Supriya Mataji. That was so beautiful. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mataji, Mia Mataji.
Yeah, in the beginning where I read, I was forgot that one point where Srila Prabhupada was telling to Aniruddha to, you know, have a big temple, and he was telling, I wanted all house to have where Radha Krishna, and like he went for the donations outside and then he could not find anything and he was joking, like, what was the news that you find today or something. That was a very nice conversation. I forgot to talk about that.
Yes,
and the other one where that Subala had no driving license and then he was driving and then police had caught him, that was also very nice.
Yes, Mataji.
Yeah, I forgot to add those 2 points, Mataji.
Thank you, Vinaya Mataji. Thank you so much. You did a great job. Okay, Mataji, then we would like to stop the session here, Mataji. So I would like to thank Kamodaki Mataji, Vinaya Mataji for joining me students Leelamrita and sharing your wonderful realizations, Mataji. Thank you so much. And I would like to have your association next week also, Mataji. So with this note, I would like to pay my obeisances. Vanchan.